Good morning, everybody, and welcome to another yoga class. Let's close our eyes and take some really nice, slow, deep breaths and just begin to really engage with the body and how it's feeling this morning. Fill the body up with the breath, exhale and let the tensions go. And just notice if you're holding any tension. It could be anywhere, even gritting the teeth or pushing the toes too firmly into the floor. But let it go and let the body soften. Move your arms, jiggle your legs. Begin to feel that you can let the weight drop down into the soles of your feet. And let everything beautifully relax. Now think about your tummy muscles and your pelvic floor. And engage those without tensing the bottom muscles. Just feel how that allows you to lengthen the spine more. And you may find that your shoulders relax and the arms become more heavier. And if it isn't happening right now, it will eventually. I'm going to go into roll downs. So I've kept my feet a distance apart. I'm going to exhale and drop down towards the floor. Head and arms heavy, feeling the stretch through the legs and the spine. You can just roll, feeling the spine stack. Let the collarbone widen and the head come up. And just go between those two movements. If you feel too much tension in the legs, tiny, tiny bend in the knees. Just waking up the spine and the hamstrings. And if you wish, you can bring the arms into it and sweep them up to the crown of the head. And exhale, bring the hands down. Continue exhaling as you're draping down. But let the head and arms be heavy. Breathing in, rolling up. Exhale, hands down and draping. Really engage with the breath, as though it's the breath that instigates the movement. It allows the body freedom. backwards as I turn my left leg out at the hip and then bringing the heel in line with the heel. Bend in the left knee, go as deep as you can, but don't force the stretch. And if it's uncomfortable in the knee, maybe don't bend the knee as deeply as you really would like. The kneecap is tracking the second of their toes. Left hand at the back of that left knee. Body facing forwards and looking forwards and exhaling as you slide the hand down the leg. Meet the stretch. Only go deeper if the stretch wears off. In is in sideways angle that the outside edge of the left side of the ribcage rests on the very top of the thigh. Once the thigh is parallel to the floor, and you can bring the arm up and over. Just engage with the breath once more, relaxing on the exhale. Now I'm going to go into pyramid pose. So I'm just turning my right foot forwards, both hands either side of the mat or even on the floor. I'm going to begin to straighten my left leg. Now I'm relaxing downwards onto thigh with the left side of the chest and just letting go. Always keep the back heel in contact with the mat so you get that beautiful Achilles and calf stretch. Bending my left knee much deeper, bringing the right foot slightly in further and coming into warrior one. And you can raise the arms up and look to the ceiling, and you can lean back. Return to centre and reposition your feet once more, and you're going to go into triangle. So right leg and foot pointing forwards, left leg out at the hip, heel in line with heel, arms out, hinge over, hand to leg, raise the back arm. You can stay here or send the top hip away and slide down the leg. But everything is in a nice straight line. the side. So hips to square, core control, left leg and foot pointing forwards. Turn the right leg out at the hip, heel in line with heel. Bend in the right knee, kneecap tracking the second or third toes, right hand at the back of the leg, and exhale, sliding down the leg, meeting the stretch. Sideways angle. Up to you if you bring the arm up and over or not. Ready? Both hands either side of the mat or the floor. Turning the left foot in. Both feet flat on the floor. Straightening that right leg. Resting, resting down. Right side of the chest gently on the right thigh. Pyramid pose. Nice deep bend in the right knee, scooting the left foot further up, coming back to centre, and we're going to go back into warrior one. Front knee bent, back foot on the floor, toes pointing forwards, raising the arms up, looking to the ceiling if you want to, and if you want to go deeper. Forwards through the hips and lean back. going to go into downward dog and go from there. Come down onto the mat. Knees and the hips, knees and feet hip distance apart. Hands in the right position for you. Fingers spread, little fingers on the outside edge of the mat. Toes under, push into the toes. Chest towards the thighs, send the hips to the floor. Push back with the pelvis, slide your right foot behind you, back into all fours, toes under, downward dog once more. Forwards to the left wrist, right knee down, sliding the right leg down the mat, pigeon once more. Pushing back with the pelvis, knee lifts, back into all fours, and come up to knee then, and we're going to dragons. Left foot forwards, left knee, sorry, left foot, right knee, hip distance apart, hands to the mat, take the right leg down on the floor, left hand on the inside of the left leg. Mat up to you if you keep the arms long, or you challenge yourself and come down onto the forearms, and then from there, toes under, back through the heel. To the wall in front of you. Don't let the head drop down. Knee down on top of the toes, up onto the hands, leg back and rest back in child's pose. Just feel that you can really let your body relax and let go. You've worked really, really hard there. And then very slowly lift the head and come back up.